G'day there, I'm Jesse Crow, the traveling scientist, and after spending years studying pharmacology, I'm here to help you live smarter, happier, and healthier lives. Recently, I created a video about getting a blood test to check your vitamin, mineral, and hormone levels. And in this video, I'm going to help you understand the results of your test. I've also made a cheat sheet that simplifies all your essential vitamins and minerals and how to balance them to maximize your health. That's totally free. You can download it from any time in the description just down below. Today, I'm going to be explaining your iron levels, looking at transferrin and ferritin. Iron is an essential mineral that we use to transport oxygen around the body, and it's incorporated into a protein called hemoglobin, which carries the oxygen in our red blood cells. Normal iron levels are between 600 and 1700 micrograms per liter, or between 10 and 30 micromoles per liter of blood. If your iron levels are lower than expected, you can't produce enough hemoglobin, and therefore you can't transport oxygen around your body properly, and you're going to suffer from anemia. So to get more iron into your diet, you can eat things like meat, tofu, spinach, lentils, beans, or you can take a daily supplement of 10 milligrams of iron. Transferrin, or TRF, is a protein that binds to and transports iron through your blood. And a normal amount of transferrin is between 2,000 and 3,500 milligrams per liter of blood. Another measurement we can look at is your transferrin saturation, or TRF SAT. This is the amount of transferrin that is in use, bound to iron currently. And a normal TRF SAT is between 10 and 50%. Finally, ferritin is a protein that is involved in iron storage throughout the body. A normal amount of ferritin is between 12 and 300 nanograms per milliliter of blood in males, or between 12 and 150 nanograms per milliliter of blood in females. If your ferritin level is higher than expected, this could indicate haemochromatosis, which sounds epic, but it's not. It's basically a buildup of iron in your body, which is really bad, so you should avoid iron-rich foods. But if your ferritin level is low, this could indicate an iron deficiency, which can lead to anemia. Anyway, there you go, guys. I hope this information helps you to understand your blood test results a little bit better. And just remember that if your results are slightly out of the average range, don't stress. Variation is very normal among different people. And if you are concerned about any of your results, you can contact your doctor and ask them for advice. And thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions for me, let me know in the comment section down below, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.